Hello, my amazing creative friends. It's Friday and Oksanta here again. I was doing a lot of things today, but one amazing thing happened that prompted the topic of this video. And I'm going to talk today about the artist samples and designer samples in the freelance projects. When you are a textile designer, a surface designer, or even actually other artist who creates creative work for your clients, and the clients produce physical projects, it's super, super awesome if you can request samples of your work to receive in the mail and to look how everything turned out, to see your work in action. It's an awesome, awesome feeling, I promise you. It's one of the most rewarding things of being a textile designer and a surface pattern designer, at least to me. And I really, really enjoyed my packages that I've been receiving from my amazing, amazing customers in the mail. So today I wanted to talk a little bit about that and also to open a package that I received in the mail. It just came yesterday and I was super excited to open it, but then I thought, okay, I'm going to open it with my creative friends live on YouTube. So if you are here today, hi, I am so excited that you are here. And if you are watching this on replay, please still comment and let me know what's going on with you, what's going on with your creative life. And what's going on with me today is that I got a cool package to open, which contains a product that I designed. Actually, I designed it together with my amazing customer, and the customer is Hessa Bags. It's a Malaysian company with big heart. They make amazing, beautiful handbags and wallets and backpacks that not only are pretty and practical, but also they send amazing message that I also share, and the message of faith and of patience and of love and of peace. That I really respect their message that they sent into the world. And it's a Malaysian company. So yeah, I really enjoy working on these amazing projects. Okay, but a few words about artist samples first. So if you are a designer or artist who works for customers who produce physical projects, it is super awesome to request samples. When do you request them? And I will just share my own experience that I have on this subject, and it worked very well for me. So in your contract, you should always have a contract before starting any freelance design or art project, and both parties should sign it. And one of the points in this contract should be that you request an artist sample. And I am just will tell you right now that the request artist sample is not only for you as an artist, but also for a client. It's very, very important. Actually, clients want you to have their samples, because as I'm doing right now, you are going to show amazing work that your customers do. You're in it together. You share this amazing project together. So I really, really recommend both clients who order art and also artists who design and designers to team up together and to exchange the products, and also to send the products to artists, because the artists can take pictures, can use them every day, or can share them on social media. It's amazing marketing opportunity for both artist and designer and client, excuse me. So please consider adding it to your contract. And I always in the first few emails when we discuss our project with the potential customer, I always ask them that this is my price, and this is I customarily also receive a sample of any produced physical product with my artwork. And in this way, I can use it on social media, on putting it on my portfolio, taking pictures, videos, and in this way, marketing my customer too. So it's actually a very beneficial situation. And please don't forget to put it in your contract. And also, you need to have an updated address with your customer so that they can mail you your sample. It is super exciting. Okay, I'm going to be sharing my own exciting sample that I received from Hessa Bags. Okay, let me get this started. If you guys have any comments, please leave them in the comments section. I promise I'm going to figure out how to use the comments. I am doing my best, but sometimes I'm not sure if I'm looking in the right place, but I will figure it out. I promise. Or at least I will try and answer all of your comments. I'm reading all the comments. Sometimes it's just very busy, so I cannot answer them right away, but I will devote one day per week of answering any comments I receive on my YouTube channel or social media or email. All right. So this, I really like the box that Casa Bags uses for their products, kind of a little box like this. It's pretty cool, huh? I really like it. All right. Let's open it. And then stay tuned for later after I open this baby. I am going to show you the whole process of how we designed it and how the whole project looked like. It was kind of an interesting process. It's just interesting how everything worked out. All right. Oh, nice. I got some cards in there too. Oh, so cool to see my patterns. All right, like there you go. So this is a beautiful card with photos that I really like, and three of these are my patterns, and this is their first bag that they did, and this one is another artist's work. But all of the rest are my patterns. I'm so excited. Oh, thank you for choosing Hessa bag. There you go. This is a nice card in there too. Great job, Hessa Bags. I love it. Okay, there's a nice sticker over here too, and a nice paper. All right, let's open it. Okay, so I have a little tag over here, and this is the tote. Okay, let me take the little plastic protection off. From there you go. Okay, nice idea. It's pretty big. I like it. It's kind of like being a mom of a toddler. I like that. I will have a tote to carry all these things for my family whenever we are on the go. So that's very cool. I think it's a good idea. It's a pretty cool size. So these are not leather bags, which I like actually. And this is a new, I actually have other samples, but oh, I like this one. It's kind of little cute coin-like details on the zippers. Very nice. I like it. That's a little bit of a playful style and sparkle in there. Yeah, it's nice. Okay, let's see. Yay! It works very nice, and these are pretty soft. And let's see what's inside. Okay, there's some papers in there, and it's pink inside. It's this super, super nice pink. Oh, it's very soft and velvety too, and has three pockets inside, and one big pocket, and one over here. This is awesome. Oh, nice. I like this velvety, soft texture of pink inside. Yes, I like it. I like it very much. I'm so happy to see my artwork on a nice product that I myself can use. Yeah, cool. Okay, there's a zipper on this side, which is kind of cool. I love to have the zipper on the outside. All right. Nice work, Hessa Bags. Okay, and let's go to the artwork. So there is this gardenia and magnolia flowers, and the words over here, there are a lot of little words that hidden in the lines, in the line art of the artwork. Let me show you up close. And this say different, basically the words are like typography in here. And let me see. And they say sabr for patience and shukr for gratitude. Yeah, so I'm really, really enjoying this feel of the bag. Yeah, and also it has also shukr and sabr, patience and gratitude on this little pattern, the repeat pattern that goes behind the flowers. And this is on the same corner, on the other side is the same, and with the words reversed. Yeah, I'm so happy. So happy, love to receive. I love to receive the samples from my work. So yeah, today I wanted to share with you guys, and let me move on to this next part of our live stream today. Please leave the comments if you have them. I will check right away and see if you guys are leaving me any comments, but I will show you right away the artwork files that I developed and how the process and how this bag was designed. All right, 1 second. Okay, let me go to the application. No, not this one, not this one, this one. Share. All right. So, suppose I'm hoping you're seeing my Illustrator window. And let me go check. Let me go check. Let me go check on the page and see if anyone is here. Okay. Okay, you guys. Let's move on to the artwork. Let me grab my chair. I'm enjoying this live video so much, but sometimes you just have to arrange things in them, which is fine. I hope you guys don't mind. All right, so this is the artwork that I did. This is the final artwork that's actually for, I can show you some more detail over here. So it's actually, the now that I look at it and in the back, the colors and the textures really came out nicely for this artwork, and the placement is actually very nice and spot on. So it's, but yeah, I'm very excited to see such a great quality of reproduction of artwork. Okay, so basically the Hesse bags contacted me and they wanted this particular concept with patience and gratitude on the flowers. And it was their idea, the owner's idea, to include these flowers and this concept. So I developed flowers. This was actually the second try for the style of the flowers. But these were like a little bit more simplified style. And I also, since the elements were pretty simple eyeliner, I added this watercolor texture in there. Let me see if I can go inside and show you guys. There you go. So basically it's a super detailed, since it's vector, the watercolor texture is actually vector texture. So that makes a file ginormous. But I painted myself the watercolor texture. I live traced it and put it on the file, so it makes actually the file very large, and my Illustrator is a little bit slow. All right, let's see. Okay, so this is the final artwork, and but before I had this watercolor texture, I only had the white flowers. That was the original request, white flowers, and then we added the texture in there, and this is the concept that I developed for the corner. But then actually, since the patterns are very versatile, so that's most of my work are patterns, but for some particular reason, I really like the corner design. So the patterns, I actually made also a pattern version of it, and my customer really liked the corner design. So sometimes you have to develop a few things, and you can see that I actually created a mock-up. I didn't know how the proportions of the bag at that time, so I just came up with some proportions. But let's see. So this was the final mock-up of the, this my own mock-up with the artwork in there. And what actually I needed to do, since it's mirrored on the other side, the words would have been mirrored too. So what I did, I created two different artworks with mirrored words. So this, in this particular case, they are, I flipped this JPEG to show you guys, but there are two, basically the front of the bag and the back of the bag with the zipper are two different artworks. They are the same, only the words are mirrored. All right. So for the black ebony kind, so this, you can see, I always love to see how the mock-up and the bag look. So I actually think that the final proportions of the bag are much cooler, much more modern. So I'm very happy how Hesa Bags arranged the actual proportions of the bag. That was pretty cool. So I really like, now comparison with my mock-up, the artwork fits the same, but I think the nice long, the shape of the actual tote and the nice long handles are very nice. I like them. It makes the bag much more elegant, and the inside is very cute and pink. I like that too. Very soft, but also still elegant. I like it. So this is the photo from Hesa Bags with their bag. And next, what came next was that we developed another colorway. It was a brown colorway, chocolate brown with kind of cream yellowish watercolor. So this one is a caramel face tote. And what happened was I also made the mock-up. And there's the caramel bag. It's also very nice. And there's the Hesa Bags kitty, one of their kitties, eating, munching on the bag. So I think he enjoys it too. And yeah, that's pretty, I like this photo. I think it's fun. So this is what we came up with. This is the second bag. So now they have two colorways, one in pink, black, white, and green and pink. And this one is shades of brown, green, and cream, like yellow color. So this is it, you guys. So that's the project that, how it worked out. Oh, I see some comments over here. Hello, Eliza, Eliza, hi. Thank you for kind words. And hi, Ana Carmen. Oh, it's Spanish, gracias. Nice, yes, de nada. That's all I know from Dora the Explorer. my Dora and I, we learned Spanish a little bit from Dora. Thank you, guys. Yeah, thank you for watching. I really appreciate that you guys are here. And please. Yeah, that's basically it. Let me switch back to my video. Okay. Yay! So, yeah. So I'm back here in my studio today with my new bag, super lucky. I'm really excited to try it out, take some pictures with it and see how it's, I already can see it's very nice, very practical and also special. I don't really see bags similar to this in local shops here. So yeah, I always like something special to mix into my wardrobe. So I'm excited about that. And it has actually this little knob over here. Hmm, pretty cool. Yeah, like it. I'm actually almost every day I'm using their backpack for our, let's say a diaper bag. Yeah, kind of diaper bag for my toddler. Whenever we go anywhere, I carry it all everywhere with us. So thank you so much, Hesa Bags. It's been super helpful in our family life. I love it. And I'm super excited for other projects to come and what we're going to develop next. And yeah, this is it, I think. All right, let's see if everything is in place. Yes, you guys, so if you have any questions about how to set, how to ask your customers for client samples and what to do with them, I would definitely take pictures of them, actual photos in different settings with yourself. Like I'm planning to get my husband to take some photos of me with my new bag and talk about your project. Talk about your clients and how awesome they are and your process. So basically that's my method, and I think it benefits everyone, and it lets you know that you appreciate your customers too. And I really appreciate mine. They are amazing people and I'm lucky to be in a team with them. So you guys, I will go back to the comments if you want to leave some comments and ask some questions. I promise I will answer your questions if you left them on other videos. Within a few days, I will set myself together, put myself at my desk and answer all your comments, I promise, and also emails, Facebook messages that you might have left me. So, okay, I have some plans to do some more work today until I just have a few more hours until my daughter is off from her preschool. And thank you once again. I hope you have amazing, amazing creative week. Let me know your ideas or questions or suggestions in the comments down below. Like this video if you liked it. It really helps me out. And share it if you know somebody who might use this information that I shared with you today. Okay, guys, have a great creative weekend. Bye-bye. Mwah! Grow, love, and create. Almost forgot.